Friends, welcome to EduTap. So welcome to this lecture part 2 of agricultural engineering. So friends, as part of the part 1 lecture, what we did is we actually understood what this particular discipline is all about, right? Then we had in detailed discussion regarding farm mechanization, like the day-to-day activities that are performed in agriculture. Basically, you make use of various tools and implements to do so, right? So basically, at the end of the day, what you're doing is you're making your job simpler, right? Which would actually increase the productivity, okay? So now we saw that when you have a look at farm mechanization as a process, there are various steps or process involved. Okay, for example, you're doing land leveling, right? Then you're moving ahead, you are actually preparing the seed bed. Okay, then you have sowing taking place. Yes, then you have the weeding and interculture operations, then you have harvesting. So these are the subsequent steps that are usually involved in the agricultural operations, right? So as part of the part one lecture, what we did is we saw each of these in a detailed manner, right? At the end, what we did is we were having a look at interculture operations, and for weeding and interculture operations, we saw that there are certain equipments that are used. They can be hand hoe, right? They can be long handle weeders, they can be cultivators, right? So each of these we had seen them in detail, and at the end there were cultivators which we need to discuss, and we shall take it up in this particular part. Okay, so here you can have a look at this picture wherein you can see that there is a cultivator that is there on your screens, right? So here the cultivator on your right hand side is basically tractor drawn. Okay, so again we are going to see that cultivators can either be animal drawn or they can be tractor drawn as well. Okay, so let's see for what is it used. So we have already seen that this is used as one of the interculture operation equipment, right? So it is basically can also be applied for seed bed preparation and for sowing with seeding attachment, okay? So you need to understand that some of the equipments, they are having multiple uses. Okay, like this one, mainly after the standing crop you use it to remove the unwanted plants, okay? Plus there are various other interculture operations as well. Now again, when I'm talking about interculture operations, or when I'm talking about after tillage operations, I'm referring to a kind of tillage operations that we do once the standing crop is available. Okay, so now you need to link these things to the earlier parts where we were discussing in basics of agriculture. We have very deeply understood what is tillage, what are the various classifications of it based on the various factors, right? So immediately when we are talking about cultivators, you need to go back in your memory, you need to try and retrieve those information, right? Only then you'll be able to understand and make sense of what we are trying to discuss out here. Okay, so as I told you, it is used for interculture operations, plus it can also be used for seedbed preparation and sowing. Okay, so now there can be different types of cultivator. You have disc cultivator, okay, you have rotary cultivator, and you have tine cultivators. Fine. Now, why do we have this classification? Based upon the equipment, so the tools with which it is attached. Okay. Like for example, in the case of disc cultivator, it is fitted with disc. Okay. And in case of rotary cultivator, you can have blades. Okay, which is mounted on a horizontal shaft. Okay. You have tine cultivator. It is fitted with tines which are having shovels. Now there are two things, like you have shovels and sweeps, which we were seeing in the earlier lectures as well. So basically these are those equipments that are attached to the already available implements in order to till the land. Okay, it can be used for fine turning of the soil. Okay, it can be used for slight digging of the soil. So these are these sharp implements. Okay, so when you talk about sweeps, these are basically V-shaped ones. Okay, and when you talk about shovels, they usually have blunt ends. Okay, they can be square in shape or they can be cylindrical like this. Okay, like a sharp end, blunt end, sorry. Okay, so in the further sections, we will have a look at the picture, so you will be able to differentiate between what is a shovel and what is a sweep. Okay, so you need to just understand that based on our requirement or based on the kind of soil which is there in a particular place, we choose this, whether we need to attach a shovel or whether we need to attach a sweep. Okay, so these are some of the you can say fringe implements that you need to understand about. Okay, so basically what does a cultivator do? Okay, it stirs the soil, great, and it breaks the clods, okay? See, now one thing you need to understand that immediately when you're going to sow crops in a field, you do certain tillage operations, that is before the cultivation of crops, okay? At that point of time also, your motive is to break the clods. You need to actually make the soil loose. Okay, because after repeated cultivation on a particular land, because of the repeated climatic conditions like maybe sunlight or maybe rainfall, what happens is the soil undergoes certain pressure and there's a compact nature of the soil that is seen. So that is not required for sowing. Okay, so you try to loosen up the soil so that proper aeration is there, proper drainage of water is there, and that is why you perform tillage operations. Now what happens is even after you have sown the crops, there is a possibility that there are clods or clumps of soils that are formed. This is again because of the climatic conditions or because of the regular watering that we keep doing, right? So it is very important for us to keep a check and keep performing certain operations even on the standing crops, okay? So for that we are using certain tools that we have been discussing, hand hoe we have been discussing, long handled weeders we have been discussing, and cultivators are one of them. Okay, so basically they're stirring the soil, they're breaking the clods. Okay, now the tines, or you can say these are blades which are fitted on the frame of the cultivator, comb the soil deeply in the field. Okay, so these blades are used to actually go deep into the soil and help in stirring and breaking the clods. Okay, so there's one important interesting point rather here, that if you talk about cultivator, they perform certain functions which are intermediate between plow and harrow, right? So you can see that plow is a primary tillage equipment and harrow is a secondary tillage implement, okay? So basically plowing is just you are digging up the soil, making it loose, and when you go for harrowing, you are going deeper into it, you're breaking the clods. Okay, so when you see a cultivator is somewhere in between where it does both these operations in a better way, plus it can also help to a certain extent in destruction of weeds, okay, which is actually its primary function. Okay, that is why we place it under the category of, you know, used for intercultural operations, right? So you need to keep these important points in mind. Okay, now again, quickly let us have a look at the important functions that are performed by the cultivator. So it basically destroys the weeds in the field, very important, the primary function. It aerates the soil for proper growth of crops, right? It conserves moisture by preparing mulch on the surface, okay? To sow seeds when it is provided with sowing attachment. Now remember, I told you that there can be equipments with multiple uses. Okay, so this is one of it, like, you know, if you attach it with certain sowing equipments, then obviously it will help you to sow the seeds, right? And it prevents surface evaporation and it encourages rapid infiltration of rain water into the soil. So if you see, it has a whole lot of advantages, and that's why cultivators are very prominent and they are used these days a lot. Next, if you see, as I told you at the start of the lecture when we were having a look at that picture, that cultivators can be tractor drawn, right? They can also be animal drawn. Okay, so this categorization is basically based on the power which is available for the implement, right? So in agricultural part one lecture that we were going through, we actually had an understanding that you know, like how we human beings need food, which acts as a fuel, gives us the energy to do work. Similarly, each of the equipments also requires certain power, right? And the modes of power can be different, right? Human beings can pull the equipment, so we are giving the power to it. It can be animal drawn, so animal is giving power to it, right? So it can be tractor drawn. So how is it deriving power? From the engine of the tractor, right? So now here you need to remember PTO shaft, okay? That is power takeoff shaft that we had actually studied, okay? So this is important. Again, we had seen that basically the equipments are attached to the tractor and those equipments take power from the engine of the tractor through PTO, right? So remember those concepts very well. Now this tractor drawn can also be placed in a different category, like it can be trailed type or mounted type. We are not going to go into the detailed discussion of it. Just understand that there can be two types of it, right? Okay, now the other thing is as we have mentioned that in cultivators there are certain equipments which are attached to it. Okay, let us see what. Now if you see in the picture, you can see here in the left hand side there are certain V-shaped blades like thing that is attached. Okay, this is nothing but called sweeps. Okay, and as I told you, these sweeps have V shape. You can have a look at the picture here. Then on the right hand side, you can see these are having blunt ends. Okay, these are called shovels. Okay, basically shovels can also have rectangular ends like this. Okay, so these are again those fittings with the help of which the actual cutting of the soil is done. Okay, now these shovels and sweeps are also of different categories. They can be single point shovel, they can be double point shovel, right? Spear head shovel, sweep, half sweep, or furrower, right? Now you need to remember what is a furrower. We had been discussing this in the previous chapter. For opening the furrows, you use certain equipments, okay, that is attached to the seed drills, which were called furrowers, right? We had also seen the types of it. So try and link these things to the previous lecture. Only then you will get a complete understanding of the entire chapter, right? Fine. Now if you see, now you would ask me, how do I select a shovel or a sweep, right? So this all depends upon the type of soil, okay, the type of crop and the weeds influence, okay. For example, wherein you have a hard terrain, okay, you would try to come up with that kind of a sweep or shovel. It will penetrate there easily, okay. So you need to understand these requirements, and that is why you need to understand the area where you're going to perform these operations. That is very important. Okay. Now, if you see these shovels and sweeps, they should be operated as shallow as possible. Okay. Because we need to prevent the pruning of roots from the plants. See, what happens is if these equipments go deep into the soil, they might harm the roots. Okay, but that is not our intention, because these operations are performed in the standing crops. You need to understand that after the crops have grown. Okay, so we need to be very careful that they should be shallow and they should not go very deep into the soil, right? Okay, now if you see, depending upon the type of soil, as I told you, the same point here, or the crop, we are selecting the shovels, right? Now here the other important point is the tractor drawn cultivators. We had seen, right, that the cultivators can be animal drawn or tractor drawn. So those which are tractor drawn, they can actually be of two types. Okay, and this depends upon the flexibility and rigidity of tines. Now, what are these tines? These tines are nothing but the blades that are attached. Okay, so here you can have a look at the picture basically. So this is a picture of a tractor drawn cultivator. Okay, and here you can see these are tines. Okay, these are blades. Okay, now there are two categorization of it depending upon the type of blades that are used. Okay, if the blades are flexible, okay, then obviously it is called a cultivator with spring loaded tines. Okay, so basically you can see that they would move enough, okay, and they are very flexible. But these blades can be rigid also. You can see at the right hand side, what happens is here springs are not attached, so they would not bend. Okay, they would be very straight, and wherever you are putting a cut, they would just go deep into it and they would just be taken back. Okay, so these are going to be very straight. So here you can see cultivator with rigid tines and cultivator with spring loaded tines, right? And you need to understand out here one more thing, that to these tines you can see shovels or sweeps would be attached. Here you can have a look at this picture, right? Now let us have a look at the various types of cultivators. So basically there is sweep, there is junior hoe, and there is duck foot cultivator, right? So wherever you see these names, just relate to the point that they are used for weeding operations, right? Where you are removing the unwanted weeds among the crops so that competition is avoided, right? So let us have a look at these equipments very broadly in a general way. So first is sweep. The first thing that should strike your mind when you hear about sweep is that it consists of V-shaped blades. Okay, this is important. So kindly make a note of it, right? And basically we require it to skim at a shallow depth of 2 to 3 centimeter. Okay, now you need to relate to the point that we were referring to earlier in this lecture, wherein we understood that these sweeps and shovels are not required to go deep into the soil. Okay, the reason being there is a chance that the roots can get injured, and again it is disadvantageous for us, right? So this is one thing that you need to know. And then you need to know the coverage. It is nearly 1.75 to 2.5 hectares per day. Okay, let's move forward to the next one. You have junior hoe. Again, what it is used for? Same thing, weeding between the rows of standing crops. Okay, see here you need to understand that when you go to each of the implement, it is not required that you memorize the parts of it, or you know, you start going detail into that particular thing. For our examination, you need to know for basically for what is it being used, okay? And these names should be registered in your mind. So it is like when you hear junior hoe, it should not be like, you know, you don't know about it. So that is important, okay? Then here you can see that it has nearly 6 numbers of curved tines which are fitted with reversible shovels, okay? So basically we have seen the difference as a shovel and sweep, how sweep is V-shaped, how shovels are quite blunt-ended, right? And the coverage is basically 1.5 hectares per day. Now you can have a look at the picture here. This is of a junior hoe, right, that we were just having a look at. So there's a shovel here, and you can see that it can actually penetrate at a shallow level into the ground, right? That is what it is used for. Then you have duck foot cultivator. Okay, now basically this comes under rigid cultivators that we were having a look previously also, that based on whether the tines are rigid or flexible, you can divide it into two. Okay, and these are usually tractor drawn. Okay, and these cultivators basically is popular in black cotton soils. Okay, and this is important point that you need to make note of, and it is usually used in hard soils for shallow plowing. So always keep in mind this shallow plowing, never forget that. Okay, and just here you can see, because it is having rigid tines, okay, these are usually made of a high fabricated material, that is high carbon steel. Okay, so these are some of the very common points, just understand them. Then here you have certain important data points for this duck foot cultivator. Now this becomes important for us, right? The number of sweeps can vary. They can be between 5 to 7. Okay, and you need to understand that this power requirement out here is an important data point. Okay, so basically you have nearly 25 to 50, okay, or 18.75 to 37.5 HP per kilowatt in case of tractor drawn. Okay, so there can be various answers for it. Okay, sometimes you know there is a range of HP that is required. Okay, so again try and relate horsepower. That is why we already discuss these terms, because you know if you don't discuss it, you will not understand what is this horsepower, why are we talking about this power requirement, right? Then there is shovel type cultivator. So basically do not get confused, it is the cultivators in which the shovels are mounted. Okay, so just a general thing. The number of tines can be 7 to 11. Okay, and you have power requirement here, same thing, you have a range which is given. Okay, now the last operation that we will discuss is regarding harvesting. Okay, so we have seen that under farm mechanization there are various processes. One of it was harvesting at the end. So basically what is harvesting? It is nothing but you're cutting, picking, plucking. Okay, you are removing the edible part of the crop, or you also remove the whole crop. Okay, so this is the last operation that is usually performed when the crops are standing on the field, right? And if you see this kind of harvesting, it can either be done manually, okay, using manually operated tool. You can also use animals for it, again animal drawn machines or mechanically operated machines, like if you are using tractor. Okay, so it's tractor drawn harvesting equipments, right? So now under this harvesting equipment, there are various terms that are used, okay, and usually there is nothing much to explain out here. So I would just tell you that take some time out, understand these things, for example, mower, Okay, so it is a machine which is used to cut the herbage crops. Okay, now herbage crops are nothing but usually the herbaceous plants. The very prominent example is grass. Okay, so basically they are just cutting those grass and they're leaving them there in swath. Okay, so this is the function of mower. Okay, there is reaper. Reaper is a machine which is used to cut grain crops. Okay, so this is very important. Just understand that this can also be animal drawn, it can be machine operated, right? Now friends, here you can see that there is this capacity which is mentioned, right? You can see this in the tabular column. Now this capacity becomes very important because in exam there is a possibility that you get direct questions on these capacities. Okay, so this is very important for you to pause the video and make sure you memorize it then and there. Okay, you have this reaper binder. Okay, now what happens is when you say reaper, it is just a machine which is used to cut the grain crops. Okay, but a reaper binder, it cuts the crops plus it ties them into sheaves. Okay, so basically you can say there is one operation here. Now in addition to this one operation, there's one other task which is being performed by reaper binder. Okay, so it cuts and binds the crop simultaneously. Now this is a simultaneous process that it is doing. Okay, now the harvesting capacity again is given, it is between 0.25 to 0.35 hectares per hour, right? Now again, these are some of the other important tools implements, like you have swath. Okay, so this is a material that is left by the harvesting machine. Okay, now we were just having a look at a mower. Okay, so in that we use this term that what it does is it cuts the herbage crops, for example the grass, and it leaves the swath there. Okay, so basically after you're cutting it, you're leaving it as it is on the ground, and that is referred to as swath. Okay, then you have an implement which is called sickle. Okay, so this is very common when it comes to harvesting. So it's a curved steel blade. Okay, and it is manually used. Okay, so we will see a picture of it as well in the coming section. You have windrow. Okay, so it's a row of material formed by combining two or more swaths. Okay, so these are certain terms that are being used. So windrower, okay, so a machine which is used to cut crops and deliver them in a uniform manner in a particular row. Okay, so here we are talking row wise. Okay, so these are some of the important terms and implements that you need to understand. Fine, now what we'll do is we will discuss some of the commonly used equipments for this purpose of harvesting. Okay, so we have already seen certain terms. Now in these terms, I would say the important ones are first thing mower. Okay, understand that. Then you have reapers, what it does. There is reaper binders. Okay, and capacity of various types of reapers and reaper binder. Then we saw a normal term which is called swath. That is not an equipment, but that is the material which is left behind by the mower. Okay. Now let us see other the commonly used equipments. One is sickle. Okay, the next is mower, self-propelled paddy harvester. Okay, you have combine. This combine is the latest lately used by various farmers. Okay, because it combines the various operations and saves time. Let us have a look at each of these now. So here again, have a look at this picture. This is called sickle. Okay, most commonly used tool manually for harvesting. So you have a wooden handle here. You can see, okay, there's this ferrule, this portion, and then there is this blade which you can see here, right? So as we said, manually operated tool, a simple one. It is used for harvesting crops like paddy, ragi, sorghum, right? So it consists of a curved metallic blade we have seen just now in the picture, and a wooden handle that also we had seen, right? Now they can be of two types. One is plain. Okay, so you can see if the blade is just plain in nature, okay, then it is called a plain type of sickle. It can be serrated also, okay, like you can have teeth on it, on the edges of the blade, so you call it as serrated, right? Next, if you see, same thing, plain sickle, the blade is smooth. Again, that's what we were discussing. In serrated, you have sharp serrated teeth present there. Okay, so this is something very general. Then you have mower, so you can have a look at the equipment here. So you can see that it is moving on the surface. These are the herbaceous crops, okay, like grass here. So what it does is when it moves through the surface, it leaves behind the material then and there, the harvesting material, which is again called swath, if you remember. So again, same thing, right? According to the cutting tool, okay, now mowers can be classified into various types. Okay, it can be slender mower, reciprocating mower, it can be horizontal rotary mower, gang mower, and flail mower, right? Next, you have self-propelled paddy harvester. So first, kindly have a look at the picture here. So let's see what it is. So basically, if you say self-propelled, what happens is it usually has its own engine, right? And what happens is it does not require the help of some other equipment, okay, to run or to do work, okay? So basically, the power is taken from the engine pulley to the harvester main shaft through compound idlers. So that is what we are referring to self-propelled paddy harvester, right? And you need to understand that the important point out here is that coverage. Okay, it is 1.5 hectares per day. We are not going to go into the discussion of basically how it is operated. Okay, that is not within the scope of our lecture. It is not needed. So do not worry. Just understand what it is and what is the coverage of it, right? So basically, what is the advantages? Obviously, when it makes use of engine, okay, so it labor requirement is going to be reduced. Okay, and larger area can obviously be harvested in a shorter time. And even if you see, these type of self-propelled paddy harvesters are actually economical. Okay, so basically the equipment combined performs the functions of a reaper, thresher, and winnower. So you can see that all the three operations are performed together. Right. So basically, reaping is cutting of the crops, and threshing and winnowing involves separating the edible part from its cover. Okay. So all these three operations together are performed by a single equipment. So you can see how important it is. Right. Then there's a difference that we can study about combined harvester. So under combined harvester, it can be of two types. Okay, one is self-propelled type. So as we were also seeing that there are certain self-propelled machines like the self-propelled paddy harvester. In the same case, combined also can be self-propelled or it can be PTO driven. Okay, so if you see self-propelled, it has got its own dependent engine. Okay, so basically you can say that the machine drives the power from its own engine. Okay, but here in PTO driven type, by now you should have understood wherever you see this word PTO. Okay, that means what? Power takeoff shaft. So immediately you should try and remember that it is something which is drawn by a tractor, and it is usually deriving its energy or from the engine of the tractor through this PTO, right? So this combine is pulled by a tractor. Okay, and the size is given here. It varies from 2 to 4 meters. Okay, you have the power requirement, because obviously now it is tractor drawn. So you need to know the power requirement as well. So these are some of the simple points that you need to keep in mind. Okay, there might be a question on this as well. Now, so friends, with this, we have come to the end of this part 2 of agricultural engineering. So far we have dealt with a lot of things. Okay, we have actually understood tractor in a separate lecture. We have seen its historical background, how is it classified, what are the important functions that it performs, right? Then we have also seen about the basics of the various terms that we use in agricultural engineering, like you talk about horsepower, you talk about brake horsepower, indicated horsepower, frictional horsepower, right? So these are some of the terms we encounter very frequently, right? Then we also saw what is PTO, that is important for us. So in general, we understood the entire process of farm mechanization. We realized that there are certain stages in it. For each stage, there are dedicated equipments, and there are equipments which can be used for multiple purposes also. Okay, so we started off with land leveling. We understood about scoops and scrapers, okay, levelers. Then we moved on to seed bed preparation, which involves the tillage operations basically, right? So for tillage operations, obviously you are making use of tillage implements, right? And this tillage implements, we will be covering it as a part of a separate lecture, right? So then we moved on for sowing. For sowing also we use certain equipments. We saw seed drill, okay, we saw seed cum fertilizer drill, and how planters are there, okay, which is again used for sowing, right? Then we moved on to have an understanding about the various weeding and interculture operations, right? And under that we saw hand hoe, we saw long handled weeders, we have star type, peg type under it, right? And then there were cultivators. For cultivators again we are seeing this particular lecture in a separate video, right? So now what we'll do is we will address some other equipments as well, like tillage implements, as part of a different session, okay? And then we shall also understand some of the other miscellaneous equipments. So till then, friends, thank you so much and happy learning.